Today we'll focus on Europe. Let's start with Germany. Great standard of living, a very developed country. Public transportation, you can drive your car at 200-300 kilometers an hour if you want to. And great research facilities. And no tuition fees for the public universities is one of the reasons why people prefer Germany. Having said that, you will have to learn the German language is kind of a drawback. Where are the study opportunities? So, you know, some of the top universities and the map of Germany where, you know, TU Munich, Dresden, Berlin. So Berlin, Munich predominantly are the main places where people end up going to. But again, you have universities spread across and it's not that difficult to travel given the great infrastructure and the developed railroads. Which are the top universities? Now again, the top universities will also depend on the area you are targeting. You're going into accounting, finance, you're going into business and management. It will vary depending on the area you go into. If you want to go into computer science, you have TU Munich, KIL, KIT, Aachen, TU Berlin, etc. Similarly for mechanical and other engineering. So some of these are more renowned for the engineering related programs. So all the TUs that you have, the technical universities, the TU9, they are more renowned for the technical or the engineering related programs. Life as a student in Germany. You will get a Schengen visa, so you can travel across any countries in EU except UK, Switzerland. Great industry collaborations. For a student, you get a lot of discounts in traveling around, and you know, you want to go and buy a beer in a pub, you will get a discount if you are a student. Job opportunities are there, Berlin, Frankfurt, Munich, Hamburg, specifically in those areas. If you go to interiors of Germany, then language barrier and all is going to be a huge problem. So you want to try to limit to the top cities. The Oktoberfest is amazing. If you are a beer person, then you want to definitely be a part of this. It's definitely in one of my to-do list in my life. Let's talk of the application process. So when you look at the winter semester, winter is basically like your October semester. So let's assume you want to go next October. So this year, August, September, October, you're basically planning what course to apply to, what college to apply to. You give your IELTS exams, October, November, December, you work on your paperwork. January to March, as the application forms and the window open up, you start applying. You will have to either apply through UniAssist or you will have to apply directly through the university website. It's one of the two possibilities. So it would be mentioned over there. There is a website DAAD where you will get all this information. So you get your results anywhere between say May, June, July. So as you start getting your results, usually by May, June, you might have it. July is when you start applying for your visa process. Okay, it takes about 1 to 2 months to get the visa done. You have to put a blocked account, put the money over there, pay the tuition fees, then apply for the visa. Okay, once you have the financial proof, getting a visa is not difficult. You usually don't hear of German visas being rejected. September, October is when you fly. You know, the earlier, you know, depending on the college start date, you go at least 2-3 weeks before your course, get used over there, get the residence permit in the first 3 months over there, and you are a part of the education system over there. If the same process, if you are looking at the summer intake, okay, you will be applying depending on, you know, you will be basically going in the for the college starts in March, right? So you want to apply maybe start of March for the college starting in end of March. So this is how the March timeline would be. And by before May, June, you have to apply for the residence permit within 3 months of landing over there. What about the finances? How much money will you be paying? You pay semester fees, you know, per semester. It could be, you know, just a nominal fee if you're going to a public university. If you are going to a private university, then yes, the charges might be more. Okay, for example, 5,000 euros per semester. The average monthly budget is assumed to be 864 euros as per the DAD website, and this is the breakdown that they have given. Again, Indians can do in less than this. You know, if you cook your own food, you share your room or apartment with someone, you can definitely save money on it. But from a visa and an application and a blocked account point of view, you assume 864 euros per month to be your approximate cost. Practical could be anywhere between around, say, 600 euros a month. Do I need to speak fluent German? For English taught programs, no. For German taught programs, you need to be B1 compliant when you apply. But yes, what people do is they go there and they spend the first year along with your studies. You also do German classes and do your B1, B2 or whatever levels you need to clear. But yes, German will help you survive over there. So from a teaching point of view, it's not required. But to survive over there, it makes a big difference. You need to learn the German language. So ideally, I tell everyone that if you want to at least do A1, A2 before you fly, and B1, B2 you do once you are there. If you are going for a German taught program, you want to be at least B1 compliant in India. How do I find a job in Germany? So there is a German format that's different than other countries' US Indian formats. So you want to make your CV as per that format and in German language. A covering letter is important. You need a profile on Xing, which is similar to LinkedIn that we use over here. There people use Xing. You have to visit the networking events and career fairs. You will find people traveling to different cities to attend the career fairs. What are the salary scales that you look at? So this would be an approximate starting salary that you are looking at. So obviously, IT and data science engineers are more in demand. IT people make more money compared to others. But you would definitely be making more than 30-40,000 euros a year bare minimum. So it's a good return on investment. But keep in mind, the taxes being high, you will not save so much money. You will be spending also on your living expenses and all those things out there, right? So you might end up saving about 10,000 euros a year, basically. Great minds of the country, you have great international exposure. The work-life balance is excellent out there, 30 paid leaves. You can have lunch at office. You can have lunch, beer for lunch in office. You know, it's very open-minded country out there. And even when you are unemployed, you get unemployment money out there as well. So what's a EU blue card and the permanent resident? So blue card is similar to the green card that you have in US. So it gives you you can work and live in any country within Europe, except for Denmark, Ireland and UK. So once you get a blue card after 4 or 5 years of working there, you can just use that card and go to any other country in Europe except those and Switzerland and go and start working anywhere you want. You have to be more than 40,000 euros to apply for a EU blue card. One good thing is your spouse can start working. You get married to someone, your wife can go there, your husband can go there and start working the next day. After you are there, once you have the EU blue card, you can work for minimum 3 years and you will get the PR. Okay, for the PR also, they'll test your German language skills. You'll have to give a German language exam. So why is Germany preferred? Low cost education model. Okay, so you know, if you don't want to spend a lot of money, it's one of the great places to go to. Great 1.5 years to hunt for a job, and once you get a job and a EU blue card, you know, in 3 years you can get a PR. You can work in Europe, and because it's easy to get a PR and immigration, you don't hear of Indians doing that because of the language barrier, and you don't save a lot of money because the salaries are not as high as other countries and you pay a lot of taxes. But that's the bottom line for Germany.